going to do an example of using L'Hopital's rule on a form of 0 over 0. Let's look at the limit as x goes to 0 of e to the x minus 1 all over 3x squared. Now first we want to check the form. So the top of this fraction, e to the x minus 1, goes to e to the 0 minus 0 minus 1 as x goes to 0, which would be 1 minus 1, which is 0. And the bottom of this fraction, as x goes to 0, goes to 3 times 0 squared, which will also be 0. So this does have a form of 0 over 0, and we can use L'Hopital's rule. So to apply L'Hopital's rule, we want to take the derivative of the top of this fraction, the e to the x minus 1, and then separately we want to take the derivative of the bottom of the fraction. So I'm going to write it like that just to remind ourselves that we're applying L'Hopital's rule. And that's going to give us the limit as x goes to 0. The derivative of e to the x is e to the x. Derivative of minus x is minus 1. And the derivative of minus 1 is 0. And then on the bottom, we're going to have the derivative of 3x squared, which is 6x. So now let's check the form again. The top of this fraction, as x goes to 0, goes to e to the 0 minus 1, which is 1 minus 1, which is 0. The bottom of this fraction goes to 6 times 0, which is also 0. So again, we have a form of 0 over 0, and we can apply L'Hopital's rule. So we'll be taking the limit as x goes to 0 of the derivative of the top, so the derivative of e to the x minus 1, and then the derivative of the bottom, 6x, derivative of 6x. And you don't need to write this step, but I'm writing it now since we're new at this, just so you make sure you remember what we're doing. And so we're taking the limit as x goes to 0, the derivative of e to the x is e to the x, the derivative of the minus 1 is just 0, the derivative of 6x on the bottom is 6. Now we check the form again, e to the x is going to go to e to the 0, which is 1, 6 is going to stay 6. So now we don't have an indeterminate form anymore. In fact, we have a function that's continuous at 0, so we can just plug the 0 in to get the limit as x approaches 0, which would give us e to the 0 over 6, or 1/6. And that's it.